A popular city pub will shut only days after diners were allowed to return as tens of thousands prepare to protest at Parliament. Stephanie Anderson is at State Parliament. Steph, is the Imperial Hotel trying to avoid overcrowding?
Yeah, they are, Pete. Management of the hotel have confirmed that they will close the doors just for the duration of the protest in an effort to allow space for the event to be playing out, but also to ensure that the number of patrons that are currently allowed inside their venue, they're subject to a number of restrictions, won't be exceeded. It's something the businesses throughout this area are going to have to think about ahead of Saturday, and it comes as the Chief Health Officer stands firm on his directives, saying now is not the time for thousands of people to be gathering together and putting their health at risk. Saturday's protest will be held on the doorstep of Steve Lichter's diner, and he'll be keeping the doors open.
It's a good cause and good people interested in a good cause.
But at a time when COVID rules restrict gatherings of more than 20, tens of thousands rallying outside Parliament is a problem for the Premier.
People should not be protesting, whether it be on this issue or any other issue. It's not safe.
Similar protests have already been held in Perth and Sydney, but here the risk of a second wave of infection feels very real for the Health Minister.
Black lives do matter. We know that Aboriginal people are more susceptible to becoming severely ill if they contract coronavirus.
We believe that we put the right measures in place to lower the risk if there is a huge spread.
Organisers have provided a long list of COVID precautions on social media, including everyone must wear a mask and bring hand sanitizer, maintain social distance, stick in the group they came with, and self-quarantine for a few weeks after the protest.
We think it's a really good idea that everybody just stay indoors and away from their vulnerable family members.
A standard alert has been issued by the US consulate advising American citizens to keep a low profile on Saturday. And while yesterday the Premier admitted it won't be feasible to fine everyone found to be breaching virus rules, the final call is left up to officers.
The rule book is out the window on Saturday because Daniel Andrews will not show consistency on this matter.
We hope that the state acts in good faith.
Stephanie Anderson, Nine News.